Drew is originally from Lawrenceburg, Pennsylvania. He currently lives in Bensalem with his wife, Rob. Drew is a writer, filmmaker, and teacher, currently working in the field of special needs. MASH is one of many projects in which he has collaborated with Charles, a creative partnership friendship that began nearly a decade ago with such projects as Forgiveness, Our Last Goodbye, and the award-winning Eye of the Nose. His many other film and media experience includes NFL films and a number of independent productions. Alongside the current screenplay that he's working on with John, Drew is also in the process of writing another screenplay as well as two books, one of which is an exploration of horror films, a genre he is particularly in, a genre he is particularly passionate about. A lifelong cinema and literature buff, Drew has a BA in Film and Media Arts from Temple University in 2006, and a Master's Award in Secondary Education, English and Communications from LaSalle University in 2009. Let's hear it for Drew Burgess.
Thanks.
service. He studied acting in Hutchinson College and found roles in theater both in school and in regional theater, eventually landing extra feature roles in several big motion pictures. At this point, music became close. He wrote, recorded, and toured nationally with several bands, most notably the April Fool, the End, the Facts, the Rage, and Road Trip, running to play both keyboards and guitar in the process. In 2004, Lombardi again became close to acting, signed with several agencies, and began modeling, taking additional acting classes. Spent his career in films, television shows, and commercials in a variety of roles, films such as Happening, Bazookas, The Movie, It Wasn't for Love, Standoff, Perfect, and Glory Rising, and The Center, as well as his popular fan favorite, Kruger, a tale of industry. Kruger, another tale of industry. The Nightmare Ends with Halloween 2, Escape from New Jersey, and This Is the Day. He has also starred in the ensemble TV series, Brotherhood of Silver, and The Underground Kings. On board, he has also moved behind the camera as well as the front, with actor, producer, and assistant director credits for an abduction, Dead Collections, and the upcoming John Blue. With John Horton James Jones, as well as actor and producer credit for the upcoming Extinction. He's also been credited with casting, location scout, and script supervisor, as well as with special effects makeup, contributing music for film soundtracks. His production company, RPL Productions, focuses on the development, publicity, and production of new film projects, such as Just Like Me, which is produced as well as acting. The company also releases past and future music projects, licensed music for film soundtracks. Martin Lombardi also wrote the screenplay for Supernatural Phenomenon, Lucia Day. With John Horton Chambers Films, he works as a publicist, assistant director, and producer for many projects, including the comedy's group series, Ghost of Lovers, which he also stars in, and Ghost Hunting reality series, Ghost Ships. He not, but not on set, he spends his time in Philadelphia and New York. Roberto.
Another thing that may not know, John McBride was a supervisor here at Miss Rexon, and he was also been a mentor to us ever since. And talking 16 years later, man, John's still helping out the kids that he worked with 16, 17 years ago. So give it up for John McBride. So I'm here to introduce the show and also say a few words about Charles and Christman. So for now, I'm just going to say Chuck because I don't feel like saying that all the time. So on a serious note, I want to say on behalf of Chuck's friend and family, we are very proud of Chuck. Your dad always said, if it were easy, everybody would do it. So I mean, clearly, we walk around, it's not can't be too easy. So as Chuck's dad said, so we are very proud of each other. And I just want to say a few things about you. Your dad isn't here right now, but he would be very proud of you. Not only for your filmmaking, but for your duties as a public servant. So Chuck works for Parks and Recreation Department. He's worked in West Philly, parts of Kensington and Juniata. So he does a lot for the kids, and he steals city chocolate whenever he can. Whenever there's any extras, that's his goal, that's his incentive. So, Chuck's a unique individual. His body is riddled with ridiculous tattoos. He has a picture of Angel from Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Some type of werewolf. I don't know what that's all about, but... And if you've ever seen Spaceballs, you know John Candy? He plays that half man, half dog. He actually has that right around his stomach area. The coolest thing about that tattoo is John Candy's mouth is just belly button. So whenever Chuck dances a little bit, moves his legs, it's kind of like John Candy's talking and dancing. And he also has a tattoo of Patrick Swayze on his ass. But that's pretty cool. I think Patrick Swayze is pretty tough. So I'll give you credit for that. His most recent tattoo is a picture of a turtle. He calls it a tortoise, but it's basically fucking turn on the shoulder. And he always says that slow and steady wins the race. It really does make a lot of sense. I mean, it took you, what, 11 years to get a bachelor's degree? He did get it, but like I said, slow and steady wins the race. On a serious note, I mean, Chuck's been doing this, making these films for about 10, 11, 12 years now. And just, let's say, about 3 or 4 years ago, he actually won Pocono Mountain Film Festival and got into like 10, 12 other film festivals. That film was called The Eye of Man. Chuck doesn't mention this, but the only reason he won the Pocono Mountain Film Festival is because of the local gay community really mobilized. Because they thought this film was about a young blind man struggling with sexuality. So they fled up the Poconos, got out of the boat for this film. The film's actually called The Eye of Manu. I mean, Chuck can't spell, so it's M-E-N with a silent W at the end. It's about some skull from Ireland that attacks young Italian girls. I don't really know what it's about. But on a serious note, when Chuck says slow and steady wins the race, I think tonight might be special. I think we're in for a treat because I think the tourist is inching a little bit further to finish line. I think this might be able to put Chuck on the map. So I think we're going to retreat tonight, and I'd like to introduce the film, Mask. And one spoiler alert, for those of you that thought Rocky Mask was in this movie, he's not. So I got nothing, and enjoy the movie.
First off, may have been a big mistake to have Jeff introduce me with all the jokes and everything, but you turned out good, so but thank you, Jeff, number one. First off, I want to thank everyone who came here tonight. I greatly appreciate it. Means the world to me that you guys came out and, you know, checked out my new movie and everything, so I greatly appreciate that. I want to thank John McBride, who basically surprised me. Walter, Anthony, Roberto, thank you so much for leaving me and helping me in part of this movie. I really appreciate that. I really do. Drew, my partner in crime and writing, thank you so much for basically coming to the almost 10 years now, so thank you very much for helping out on the script. Wendell, hey Wendell, thank you. Man of many words, Wendell, so. I just want to thank Wendell for also believing me in the last, you know, close to almost like Drew, the last 10 years now. Me, you, and Drew have been making films for the last 10 years now, so. I'm very proud of both of you guys, so, and sticking by me and being there for me. So I just want to thank you again for always being there and shooting my films. I really appreciate that. So, all of my friends out there, I really, really appreciate you coming out. I really do appreciate you, spending a Saturday night.
Thank you for coming out. I hope you enjoy the movie, and I say we just go get drunk now.